about we'll see the concept of what is meant by Coulomb's law. Now let's move on to the next concept, that will be the electric field intensity. Okay, electric field intensity. This electric field intensity is also be said to be the alternative form of Coulomb's law. Okay, so for example, just to recap some concepts from the Coulomb's law, then you will get to know very well. So here you can see, for example, I will be taking in two charges. This be the charge Q1 and this be the charge Q2. Okay, for example, I will just suppose separated by the distance, some distance be the R. Okay, for example, if I take this be the my origin 0, 0, 0, from Q1 to my origin, the distance be the, suppose I will be taking this be the my R1 bar, from Q2 to my origin, this be my R2 bar, and what will be the distance from the Q1 and Q2, that be the R12 bar. Okay, here one thing you have to be observed, whenever I have to be exerted a force from the Q1 with respect to Q2, that will become the force will become the F12 bar. Okay, and similarly, if I want to exert a force from Q2 with respect to the Q1, that will become the F21 bar. Okay, this was the concept we are discussed in the previous session. Okay, here you can see, if I want to just write, if I want to exert a force from Q1 to Q2, charge Q1 to charge Q2, that will become the F12 bar. F12 bar. So you already know what will be the Coulomb's law. F is directly proportional to Q1 Q2 divided by R square, right? So if you want to replace it by a proportional constant, you have to be K value be the, so F is directly proportional to Q1 Q2 divided by R square. So F is equal to K into Q1 Q2 divided by R square. What will be the value of K? K be the 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. This be your K value. So here this will become the 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, my charges be the Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Here that be the R12 square into main important thing, that be our unit vector. Here our unit vector be the A bar R12. How you can represent the unit vector? Unit vector A bar R12, that be equal to vector divided by modulus of magnitude of vector. Modulus of magnitude. Okay. Here this will become the R12 bar divided by, whenever you have to be applied the modulus, this will become the modulus of R12 bar. So this be the A bar R12. So replaced this in that, what will happen? This will become the 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into my charges be the Q1 and Q2 into this be the R12 bar divided by, this will become the R12 cube square plus 1, that will become the cube. Okay, next, here this will become the F12 bar. Now what I have to do means, I just want to do the divided by Q2 on both sides. What will happen? Divided by Q2 on both sides. So this will become the F12 bar divided by Q2, that be equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 Q2 into R12 bar divided by R12 cube divided by this be the Q2. Here Q2 Q2 will get cancelled to each other. What will be my final result? My final result will be the F12 bar by Q2, that be equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 R12 bar divided by R12 cube. Okay, here one thing you have to be observed. So this force by charge, that will become the our electric field intensity. Okay, this will become the high electric field intensity. That means electric field intensity that will be represented with E bar, that be equal to F12 bar divided by Q2. Okay, here you can see what will be the units for the force, that be the Newton. That be the Newton. And what will be the unit for the charge? That be the Coulomb. So Newton by Coulomb, that be your electric field intensity unit. Or you have to be tell that be the volt per meter also be possible. Okay, so finally how you can write the your electric field intensity? E bar, that be equal to F bar or F divided by Q or F bar divided by Q. This be your electric field intensity. This be your electric field intensity. Electric field intensity. Okay. So this formula is very, very important. From this formula, they will be asked many couple of questions based on your competitive examination point of view or your university examination point of view. This formula is very, very important. Okay, just remember this formula. Next thing, what I have to do means, I will be taken my this be the charge. For example, I will be this be my origin, and I will be make this be the charge some Q. Okay, this be my some position be the P. Okay, so what will happen to the electric field? Electric field, let's be like this. This be the electric field. Okay, for example, this be the some radius R bar. So if I want to take this point here also, this be like this. This be the R bar. It can't be changed, right? Okay. For example, similarly, if I want to take two opposite charges, what will happen? If I want to take two opposite charges, so this be my plus Q charge, and here this be my point P. But in the before case, what I have to do? I have to be taken that be the both are be the positive, that way they both are just repel each other. Okay, it's just moving away to the point P, right? Towards the electric field E. Now what I have to do? I will be taking the two opposite charges, this be the plus and this be the minus. What will happen to the electric field? So this be the same point B. So this be the my electric field E, and this be towards the origin or towards this plus Q. So for example, this be the origin will be taken. So my electric field will be like this. Same similarly, the radius be like this. Okay. So what my conclusion from this diagram is, if you want to take the two positive charges, okay, if you want to take some point, represented a point, okay, in the space, and you have to be taken your point be the origin, okay, the two the point and as well as your origin be the same charge, that will be the arrow will be moves towards the electric field. For example, your point and as well as an origin, whatever you have to be taken and the your charge, that be the positive and as well as the negative, that will be moving towards your origin, okay, electric field. That's the important conclusion. And one more important conclusion from the electric field intensity, that is the very, very important. So here always you have to be remember, electric field is always be moving from the positive charge to the negative charge, okay. So electric field always move from positive to negative. So that means electric field always move from positive to negative. This conclusion is very, very important when we are consider the electric field intensity. Okay, for example, if I want to take the a couple of electric fields, and what will happen to the position vectors and what will happen to the radius, let's see. Here you can observe, so for example, if I take this be my position, okay, and here this be my R bar, and for example, if I put my charge here, this be my Q1, this be my some origin like this, okay. Okay, this be my R1 bar, and similarly, if I take this be my charge Q2, and my radius be the R2 bar, and similarly, if I want to take my charge be the here, this be the Qn, my radius be the Rn bar, okay. Now what will happen, I just want to represent the dotted line with respect to the point B, with point B. So this will become the, my electric field will become the E1 bar, and similarly, if I want to represent my dotted line with respect to the point P, okay, this will become the my E2 bar, and similarly, if I want to represent my Qn bar with respect to the point P, this will become the En bar, okay. Similarly, what I have to do means, now I will be taking the all of these values, what will happen? So here E bar, that be equal to E1 bar plus E2 bar plus into so on plus N bar. For example, this will become the, what will happen to the E bar, E1 bar, that be the my K into, what will be my charge? My charge be the Q1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, and here this be my radius be the R1 with respect to the point P, so R1PB divided by R1P cube, right? And similarly, plus what will happen to the E2, that will become the K into Q2, this be the R2P bar divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R bar 2P, plus into so on plus what will happen to the charge Qn. This will become the K into Qn Rn bar Np. So this will become the 4 pi epsilon naught Rnp bar. And similarly, what I have to do means just it will be just like a sum up, right? You have to be taken the k by 4 pi epsilon naught common outside. So k divided by 4 pi epsilon naught outside common. So if I want to take the summation of I be the 1 to some capital N, okay? So 1 R n R 1 P, that will become the what will be the position vector fine, that will be the final value minus initial value, right? So this will become the R minus R1 bar divided by, so this will become the R1, so this be the Ri 1 2 3, right? So this will become the Ri, so R minus Ri whole cube. So this be the very important, this conclusion is very important. So what we have to do means we just have to be sum up our all of your electric field high intensities, that's be our required result. In the next class we will try to see the some more problems based on the Coulomb's law as well as an electric field intensity. That problems is very important. Okay, thank you.